You're listening to European Startup Universe Talks, a podcast where we meet with startup founders, angel investors, and major stakeholders of the European startup ecosystem. They let us in on the do's and don'ts of running a startup, their career story, and the process of succeeding as well as failing. In other words, everything of interest to startup nerds. European Startup Universe is a massive network of opportunities for EU tech startup founders, connecting them with the best minds of the EU tech community, with unicorn founders, known investors and experts. We have brought together European countries to join forces and launch startup programs suitable for their nation's tech founders. ESU aims to give access to opportunity for funding and expansion across EU countries. Welcome to European Startup Universe Talks. I'm Maritza, and today I am here with Mr. Ion Mokano, the co-founder of Cardio Medive. Welcome to today's episode.
Hi, everyone, and thank you for the invitation and for this great interview and opportunity for us.
And we're really happy to have you here. I would like us to begin with, can you tell me how the idea was born?
Yes, so idea was born actually in 2018 when I founded the Cardio Medive with two of my friends, Adrian Lupu and Bogdan Radu. Both of them has joined forces immediately later in our team. And the idea was to build a smart page device for patient electrical heart activity monitoring, which is ECG signal. Once we have developed the first prototypes, we kept developing the product and adding features to cover most demanding medical needs reported by our medical advisors. In this way, our device became a truly multi-parameter wearable device, being capable of monitoring 14 days of all essential parameters. In the same time, we do not inherit all the traditional constraints and limitations of a traditional health monitoring devices, which is used right now by the doctors. So, and after that, when COVID made presence in Europe in the beginning of 2020, we have identified also a huge medical hardware gap for clinical remote examination support, because at that time, a lot of telemedicine or teleconsultation platforms was launched, especially in Romania, I don't know, you know, not the old, but most of them was at the time pure software-based or web-based, like a Zoom, we are speaking right now, and we have got a lot of reports and feedback from our doctors that they will need some devices, hardware devices, to collect the data from the patient in front they speak with. And in this way, we have determined that our device, with a little effort, can meet all these requirements and to extend also not only for patient monitoring, but also for teleconsultation support for telemedicine platform. This was all the way of iterating a development of our device, how it is become right now. But the idea actually started longer, a few years before that, when my mother in 2014 was diagnosticated with cardiovascular disease, with arrhythmias at the time. And unfortunately, she was diagnosticated too late, because the traditional technologies like the holters I mentioned cannot, especially in early stage, cannot record symptoms, too short symptoms, or if they happen, so let's say once at 5 days, 7 days. And my desire was, at that time, when finally the feedback was confirmed and she was diagnosticated with cardiovascular disease, I wanted to have some medical device to monitor her or track her disease and the disease progress, and to share this data with her doctor. Her doctor is around 400 kilometers in Bucharest, and she's not from Bucharest. And I wanted to facilitate exchange of information and so on. But at that time, no such service or product was available in Europe, in all Europe, and some small startups or products from US. So that's why, in this way, I decided, I will build this product for her and for her. if nanosize devices is on the market.
Oh, so that must have, that is a very touching story, and it must have, or how do you think that affected you when you were creating that this product? Do you think that you would come up with the same idea if this didn't happen?
Yes, so yes, actually, our product evolved a lot since the beginning. At that time, the main idea was to solve this problem. I have a personal problem in order to monitor my mother disease progress and to share with her doctor. Being cardiovascular disease, the ACG is the most important parameter in such cases. But when we started to build actually the device, after first prototypes and working prototypes very good, after feedback from our doctors, some of them said, okay, looks, it's very great to have such small page and comfortable ones, but how about to add this or this sensor? Because for us, it's very important to know ourselves, for example, hemodynamic parameters of our patients, not only disease. And parameters like temperature or respiratory rate was added first. After that, we started to develop our blood oxygenation sensors, being an unusual, let's say, location, because the patch is on chest area, and none of the sensors you can find on the market or the shelf, let's say, from any suppliers, is not for this, and usually they are developed for much traditional places, like from finger or from earlobe. These places are better vascularized. So, but if you want a device to for daily usage, you cannot put let's say an clips for your finger and to walking to your work, let's say, or outside the house, or with a sensor on your earlobes. So encountering this, we decided actually, okay, we will build our own technology and our own sensors to achieve measuring all of these parameters from one anatomical place, and to compensate, let's say, disadvantages of these places by more advanced sensors, technology, processor, algorithms, and so on.
Okay. So how it must have been quite a long and intense process of trying to build a prototype. How was it? Did you have to like build a million prototypes, or how was the process?
Yes, it was a lot of iterations, because in our case, our device involves electronics, being a hardware startup, helper startup, but also involves mechanical part, which is mechanical case and so on, and software part from mobile or on web. So we have started with the product. At that moment, I'm as an electronics engineer with a background of more than 13 years, with a lot of experience developing products from idea to mass productions. I have approached this product as pure electronic device and with any other challenge from my side. But when we started to develop a product, okay, first prototype is great. It's used at that time standard electrodes. You can, some cycle rhododes, you can find them in any pharmacy. And we make first measurements, first collection of data. It works perfectly. And okay, next requirement was, let's say, for 14 days. So the standard electrodes from the market, they are not developed for 14 days, 24 hours maximum. Okay, and at this point, we figure out that we need to develop our custom electrodes page in order to stick on patient skin for 14 days, and in same time to not irritate the skin, to be water resistant, because in 14 days you need to make shower and so on. And we started 2 years long process of developing and the iteration only for this part. One biggest problem or challenge, let's say, was that we have had from the beginning three main requirements. One was that these electrodes will be disposable, and all electronics will be reusable one, rechargeable. So one requirement was to develop a system to fix or clip together quite easily these two parts. Even elderly patient or a non-technical patient can figure out how to use them without any screws and so on. This was one. Second was to, after the bonding, mechanical bonding is perfect, how to make it water resistant, because it will be there and you need to make shower. And the third was electrical contacts between between these two in quite a producible manner in order to be easy to produce in mass production. Because if you do some product, but it's quite expensive to do it in this way, in the end, it will not reach the market. So separately, all of these three requirements was quite easy for from engineering point of view, but achieving all of three together from our point of view was a lot of iterations, mechanical, electronical, hardware, with a lot of 3D printings, with a lot of solutions, how to make it, how to stick it, by sliding, by clipping, by rotating it. In many, many iterations was done until we have coming up, my colleagues, mechanical engineers, coming up with this final solution we have right now. And being a medical device with like any hardware startup with longer cycle and so on, a lot of attention from our side was also involved in intellectual property. So we have done an FTO, freedom to operate, research from the early stage in order to assure that our device in the end it's an innovative ones, and our investor will be assured, the investors with a good product to go further.
Yeah, absolutely. How was the, speaking of that, how has that the funding process been?
Okay, so in the funding process, at the time, Romanian ecosystem was at the beginning, let's say, or early stage. It evolved a lot in last past year. We have tried to reach and to raise an let's say early stage or seed funding round, and we have had some meetings with few investors, but conditions and they put it and money they supposed to invest was not so much helpful for us, and we decided to bootstrap, me and all of my team, and to put in game our own money until the product will work and we can show it actually in front of investors and look, okay, this is the product. We reach this phase with our own effort. From this and further, we need to have a partner, investment partner alongside with us to speed up and to go further. In hardware development, especially in medical ones, the cost increase exponentially with the development, because at some point each clinical trials or on human validations cost a lot, and in the end the CE mark or approvals to medical approvals to put the device on the market also cost a lot. So our strategy was to build a device, and in order to show to the investors that okay, we handle it to mitigate the commercial risk and the technical risk. We have mitigated commercial risk by signing a lot of collaborations with our future strategic partners and clients. They analyzed our product and quite impressive about it. So we have a lot of, let's say, letter of commitments from them that they will buy and vend our products. So in this way, we have mitigated commercial risk, but the product we are building someone want to pay for this product, and it's solve actually real medical needs and real problem. And the technical problem and technical risk, which is also a good point for any investors, or we have mitigated in bootstrap phase by passing through this R&D phase by our own effort.
How was that? Because that is a bit risky, maybe. How did you find the courage to like manage to go that direction?
Yes. Wow, courage. I'd say if you start this in this way, or let's say if you on the plane and you open already the parachute, is no back way. So only on the stride. So this was also our case, and all the challenging we have faced it. As I mentioned, the page, the skin of a patient is a living human being, so it's an organ. It's not like you stick some stick to your fridge and it stay there as many as you want. And a lot of iterations, a lot of substrates, a lot of various adhesives, and a lot of tests on ourselves and me and my team. After that, on our let's say mothers and so on, we have tested. This was in the beginnings, but in the base is the commitment of courage is from the commitment of my team, and very passionate about what we are trying to solve, and our hope that some days in we will improve quality of life of many patients, and our product will be in many as possible home.
So how was the process of building the team? Do you have any tips on how to build a solid team?
Yes, some teams will be, let's say, in the beginning, the team is the biggest asset you will have, even bigger than an idea of a startup. So, for example, we have started three guys at the beginning, and we have encountered a lot of, let's say, challenging to involve in our team medical advisors, good medical advisors. Usually the good doctors is a busy ones, so to treat the patient and so on. And how you reach these doctors, they are passionate and want to be involved in such a startup and so on. So for us, one way was when we started to speak publicly about our startup in various competition accelerators or interviews, interested engineers or medical doctors who are trying by their own to solve similar problem in last past years or maybe last past decade. We have in our team a few doctors, they from 20 years so now try to solve this problem, arrhythmia problems in the patients in various ways. And even they are not engineers, but they have spot the trends, the technology evolving, the internet and so on. And when these kind of people heard about us, what we're trying to, they came to us. So in this way, we have increased our team, also technical team and medical advisor team.
Okay. Oh, you were quite lucky then that it was the other way around, not you having to hunt people. It was, you know.
We have tried, let's say. I don't say we don't know tried, but being a long trip, let's say, a hardware startup, medical ones with a lot of R&D is not like to building a mobile app, let's say. You can, in mobile app, you can have in 6 months an MVP, you can launch with proper funding, you can launch in 9 months, 1 year, and already to have a revenue and to see the results. In hardware startup, when you assume that at least 3-4 years you need to be by your own, not too many have courage to be alongside of you for such a long trip. And we have tried, as I mentioned, but our team, we are right now five core team technical members, and our maximum peak team was 12 members. Stays, let's say, up to the end, and I hope up to the end will be with us.
Absolutely. Yeah, I can really imagine that it's totally different to build something like this than, as you said, to build an app. What would you say is the biggest challenge of being a startup founder in this, in the medical field?
Yes, my opinion is the biggest challenge is to validate that what are you trying to solve is actually an real problem, and all the effort is in balance or is less than the problem impact of a problem you are solving. Otherwise, if too much effort and for and the problem is insignificant one, so not so big one, you will have a lot of problems to attract investors, to attract team and so on. In our case, we are trying to solve cardiovascular disease and respiratory one, and both of them are number one killing in the world. First place is cardiovascular disease, the number one killing in the world, and the second place is cardiovascular disease. So the medical needs in our case was quite easy to prove, but the iteration of a product and how we solve specific problem suffered a lot of iterations during our value proposition, when we defined our value proposition and the primary differentiators, key differentiators from our competitors. And actually, in our case, it was around 2 years of iteration for value proposition and key differentiators.
Okay, that's impressive.
Yes,
for sure.
Thank you.
Since you have now some solid experience being a startup founder, what advice would you have to early stage startup founders? That do you have like a top three? These are the things that I've learned to share with others.
Yes. So one thing will be, let's say, if you are not passionate about the needs you are solving, medical needs especially, don't do it. There are a lot of many more other good ideas, startup ideas in non-medical grade, much easiest one to achieve and to pursue. Other thing will be not to ignore the intellectual property importance of intellectual property, because at some point this will be very important, especially after a lot of R&D and a lot of years of involvement of R&D development, and at some time any investors will require or ask for this. So a special care from the beginning of this. And the team, as I mentioned, in our case, the team is the primary key to have a good team and visionary advisors, medical advisors around you, because the engineers in such kind of startups, the engineers and doctors are trying to solve one problem. So a good and easy collaboration and instant exchange of information between them is very important. Our luck is that we have such kind of relation with our medical advisor. For example, I can send a recording from our lab to our doctor, even at let's say late night, midnight or late o'clock, and I'm sure it will analyze it and will come back immediately with a feedback in order to go further with calibration, adjustment, and development, or whatever we are doing there.
I can imagine that it's really important. Also, as you said, when there are medical doctors and then engineers cooperating, now they're trained in these totally different fields. So the communication and the chemistry must be so important for them to really be able to work together.
Maybe I will repeat myself, but another important thing is to have a clear plan how to mitigate commercial risk and technical risks. Comparing to software, you have an R&D, some R&D, which is a technical risk, and the commercial risk in hardware is quite high because of a longer cycle of prototyping comparing to software, and higher cost, higher time consuming to have first prototype, second prototype, and you need to know clear what you are doing and what you are trying to solve. So technical risk, if it's possible to pass through as fast as possible through technical risk R&D phase, and to raise money and to move forward with development and define of your solution.
I understand. And I also, maybe this type of products is also something that it is really, really important that they actually work, and there must be so much that goes into making it work and to really make sure that you are, okay, this is a product that truly works because it is such an important product. It's another thing if you launch an app and the app doesn't work. Okay,
right,
well,
right,
then it's
right.
Nobody, like nobody's health is affected by it in that sense.
Right, an endorsement of the solution or it works actually is quite important, and any investor will ask for this kind of proof. But the timing is quite important, because you can make you can acquire data from your lab, let's say, but if you have not yet cleared the patent or intellectual property rights to protect yourself, it's quite challenging how you show this data to investors, or how you make let's say an extended clinical trials on the extended cohort of patients if you don't have yet this this kind of patent. So patent is very important. This is why I mentioned it's better to take care about it from the beginning, because it takes sometimes some many weeks to write it, to submit it, and a year and a half to get some feedback about your patent. So it's good to do it at the beginning in order to not wait for this phase to be ended, and will impact your future clinical trials and so on, and will depend on the clearance of a patent and so on.
Mm, yeah, that's good good for others to know. What would you say are the future goals and plans for CardioMediv?
For CardioMediv, right now we are in final stage of submitting our patent. So I hope in a few weeks or a month, and so we will submit our patent. And right away after this, we have prepared with our partners to start first clinical trials on humans on real environment settings. Let's say all the tests we are done right now is either in our lab or on our parents. But after public disclosure, after patent to be submitted, and we can make a public disclosure, we will enroll a real cohort of patients, and we'll start our first clinical trials. After that, we'll continue development and hope to reach as soon as possible to freeze the design, submit for CE mark in first stage and the FDA in second phase to get medical approvals and to launch the product.
Okay, that's exciting plans ahead.
One another important thing, right away after clinical trials, these first clinical trials in our case, we will announce a public fundraising investment for us to raise. Will be first one. Till now we have bootstrapped, and with all the investment from our side or myself, our parents and so on, starting from this, we will extend our team and we'll announce our first fundraising to get an investor alongside with us.
Well, that is exciting news ahead, so I really feel that people should tune in to get updated.
Thank you, I hope so.
Yeah, and before we wrap up this today's talk, would you like to add anything?
Anything you want to solve or to build based on some real needs you want to to solve, to be sure that all your skills you have behind will help you to, and is in domain of your expertise. In our case, our product was multidisciplinary ones. It involves mechanical, electronic, mobile, and acquiring all of these resources, especially in early stage, is quite important to know what you can based on, and if you have this proper expertise in your team.
Do you often see that like startups in the medical field are trying to launch a product that there is no really, really great need for?
We saw some product, but not so many, because in medical field, this kind of is quite rarely to happen, because the process is quite, let's say, known and standardized. Even the process you develop the software and the way you develop the sensors and their tolerance, all of them are standardized. So you need to be compliant of all of these development standards. In this way, in the end, after the product validations and so on, this guarantee that the quality of a product or the product will work as you say. So in medical field, if you say that the specification of a product is this or this, in the end, it will work in this way. Otherwise, if they are not compliant, you will exclude them or you will get the certification later. Comparing to consumer grade devices, when you can develop as you want, as fast as possible, even to make an MVP, to launch it, and after that, let's say 6 months, 1 year to launch another versions. In medical field, you cannot do this, because all the certification process, it take a lot of time, clinical validations, clinical trials, and cost a lot of money. So the life cycle of medical product is much, much longer. And for this, you need to be sure from the beginning that value proposition and your key differentiators is quite unique, and you will have enough differentiators and value proposition even after 2 years, 4 years, when the product will be launched, comparing to your competitors. You need to assure somehow also this thing.
It has been a great pleasure talking to you today.
Me too, and thank you very much for this opportunity and for this great interview.
You've been listening to European Startup Universe Talks. If you want to know more about us, go to thestartupuniverse.org and follow us on social media.